As I mentioned, we do have some things to talk about in this hobby. We love some news, notes, and nuggets from around the web. So let's kick it off with a look at this week's hobby happenings. And the reason I didn't answer your question, Chris, it's the first thing we're going to talk about.
Oh.
First up, Sports Collectors Daily provided an update to a story we told you about a few weeks ago. You might remember that a recently discovered full case of 1979-80 OPC hockey cards, likely containing at least two dozen Wayne Gretzky rookie cards, had made its way to Heritage Auctions as one of the marquee items in their winter Platinum Night event. It's the only known sealed case to exist. The case sold for $3.72 million late this past Saturday night. It's the only known full case still in existence. It'd been purchased and stashed away by a collector in Saskatchewan around the time of issue. According to Heritage Auctions, the case had largely been forgotten amid a large array of items before a family member recently contacted the company upon its discovery. Case contained 16 boxes of 48 packs with 14 cards per pack.
Wow.
So the case contains 10,572 cards. Upon arrival in the U.S. earlier this year, the case was opened and each individual box was authenticated and sealed by Baseball Card Exchange, the hobby's preeminent sealed wax specialist. SC Daily points out that, interestingly, the case sold for significantly more than the only known unopened 12-box case of 1986-87 Fleer basketball that netted $1.8 million at Collect Auctions in August of 2020, which I did find very interesting, the disparity between the two. A PSA 10 OPC Gretzky rookie card sold for $1.29 million in 2020. Only two out of more than 10,000 graded by PSA have been graded gem mint. PSA 9s routinely bring in over 100,000 each, while 8s have been selling for over 10 grand. However, inconsistent centering often plagues these cards, as well as displaying edges that look like they were cut with a butter knife.
Yeah, pretty bad they are, but always a nice little find, the OPC. As impressive as that sale was, Rob, SC Daily confirms that the case wasn't the only item in the auction to reach seven figures. A 1952 Topps Mickey Mantle graded PSA 8.5 netted $2.37 million. It's one of five graded at the near mint, mint plus level by PSA, with only nine higher. The card more than doubled the record price for the grade set in 2016. The last PSA 9 to come to auction went for $5.2 million in January of 2021. The card earned this week's Flip of the Week honors, as Alton Insights was quick to point out that the card was originally acquired through Memory Lane in 2010 for $154,700. That's a 15 times increase and 22% annually. Yeah.
Good on that guy.
Can't go wrong with Mantle.
A Texas auction company is selling items from storage units belonging to former pro football running back Adrian Peterson, including memorabilia from his NFL career, and it's causing quite the controversy. SC Daily reported that Peterson's 2007 Rookie of the Year Award, his 2015 NFL Player of the Year trophy, numerous milestone game balls, and other items are for sale through Tex-Mex Auctions in Houston. However, Peterson took to social media to dispute reports that he has unpaid bills, saying the auction company wasn't supposed to sell the most valuable items. I did not authorize the sale of any of my trophies, and I will be taking legal action, Peterson said in the video. quote, trusting this company wasn't, or without supervision, was my mistake. We allowed them to go into several of our storage units with clear instructions, and they clearly did something unlawful. I want to emphasize that I'm financially stable and would never sell off my hard-earned trophies. And if I was going to sell them, I know people that I could sell them to. I wouldn't go online and sell my personal items randomly. The auction was set to run through today.
Also from Sports Collectors Daily, eBay has launched its second marquee auction of trading cards. The company curates groups of higher-end trading cards for the events, which run 10 days. Over 400 items are listed, all from a variety of sellers. Among the cards being offered this time are multiple Jackie Robinson rookie cards, a PSA 7 Wilt Chamberlain rookie, PSA 10 copies of the 1981-82 Topps Larry Bird and Magic Johnson, one of the 50 1999 Skybox Premium Ken Griffey Jr. Star Rubies cards, which is a PSA 8, a BGS 10 Black Label 2015 Upper Deck Young Guns Canvas Connor McDavid rookie, a PSA 10 1986-87 Fleer Charles Barkley rookie, and that's set's toughest PSA 10, Johnny Moore. The auctions are all hosted on a dedicated page.
Well, by all accounts, this past weekend's Topps Rip Night was a resounding success. Watch this.
Tom Brady, it's your boy Meek Mill.
Damar Hamlin.
Daryl Strawberry.
Yo, it's Anthony Richardson.
Bryce Young.
We are here in Arizona at Hobby Night, man. Everybody.
Yeah! Let's have a day, baby. Yeah!
You keep all your cards.
Okay, you're gonna sign it?
Yeah. Oh my God.
Signed, great.
Rip, not.
Oh! Shipper Jones right here. Meek Mill right here. Look at this crowd. The energy is fantastic.
Thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
My favorite too. My
welcome
favorite
to the hobby.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's score!
I'll be over there trading some cards. If you got some good cards, trade them with me.
Rip Night is a great opportunity for me and for everyone just to be able to connect with fans, connect with people here around the community, and have fun.
That's unreal.
I'm Steve Aoki, and it's a wrap on Topps Hobby Rip Night. Oh!
That looked like it really hurt, that kick shot. That looked painful.
Also, remember that the story we shared last week about Topps' first cards?
Yeah.
Well, scratch that. This week's Topps released a statement saying that the cards were inadvertently released without the stamped designation on the card front. The cards are still identifiable by the very tiny one-of-one in the lower right-hand corner on the back of the card. Topps is offering to stamp the cards and issue a credit for the trouble. Impacted collectors can log into their Topps.com account to file a claim.
Well, after all of the hype surrounding the alleged 1916 World Series Babe Ruth game used glove, it appears it will remain just that, alleged. Heritage ultimately pulled it from the auction, citing concern about the item's authenticity.
Collectors Holdings, parent company of PSA, will acquire competitor SGC. Collectors CEO Nat Turner confirmed the acquisition of Sports Collectors to Sports Collectors Daily. The deal will bring two of the hobby's top four trading card authentication and grading companies under the same ownership. Action Network's Darren Rovell reported Wednesday night that the two companies would continue to operate separately.
And finally, a very special happy birthday wish to Upper Deck. On this day, 35 years ago, a new trading card company entered the market. It was called Upper Deck and debuted at a then crazy price of $1 a pack. The product featured tamper-proof packs, no gum, glossy cardstock, and counterfeit-proof holograms. Mm-hmm. And truly, the hobby was never the same, as it also gave us one of the most iconic rookie cards of all time. Happy birthday, Upper Deck. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.